Welcome to Making Waves Podcast. I'm Spencer Harmon, president of WAVV. Join me as we explore how to scale your business through prospecting with top experts who share their secrets to success. Now buckle up and let's start making waves. I really want to talk about both of your journeys kind of individually, and then how you met and started working together. And yeah, just when high level came into play. So maybe let's start, Marla, with you, and then we'll go to you, Melissa. But Marla, give us kind of your background and what got you interested in this marketing and everything that you're doing.
Gotcha. So, I mean, like in a nutshell, not to go too far back, but you know, corporate, you know, marketing degree, government work, all of the things, started an agency, and I was constantly having to like duct tape all of these different platforms together, and every single client that came through, we was like, okay, I was like setting up active campaign and all of these different things to make, you know, the entire journey for my clients to, you know, to make it a usable experience for them. And so I was doing lead generation and nurture sequences and all of the things, right? And really creating essentially a business in a box for my clients. And I was one of the industries that I focus heavily in is real estate investing. And so high level came along, and it was really an opportunity to just like remove all the duct tape and to build out all of the things that would be good for for real estate investors. And so that's what I did. And since then, I've just been like creating additional software and additional features, even, you know, with software development projects and different things like that. So that's a little bit about my history. And then, so if you want to jump into Melissa's history, and then we can kind of talk about how we met.
Let's go into that, Melissa.
Yeah, kind of the same thing, only different industries. Marketing, sales, and technology, that triangle is really my area. And yeah, so while I've been in marketing forever, I also owned a sales training company for 11 years. So, and it was called Integrity Selling. So I always point that out because I want people to not be embarrassed or ashamed or feel bad about being in sales. Sales is one of the nicest things you can do for other people because you're helping them solve problems.
Right.
And
yeah,
that's the way we always came at it. And then I sold that business to be a stay-at-home mom and had three kids and was home for a number of years. I was able to afford to do that by selling it. And then I went into factory automation and robotics. I stumbled upon it.
Okay.
It actually was
a little different than sales, though.
Yeah, it was interesting because in that world, back before COVID, the way they sold was they took donuts on Fridays, or they bought pizza, or they took them for tacos. That's how they sold in industrial sales. You went, you visited everybody, and you brought them food. Matter of fact, I just met with a friend of mine a few weeks ago, and he said, yeah, since COVID, everything's changed. Nobody wants to see you. Nobody wants to talk to you. But I was this weird marketing girl that was coming in. And yeah, I was the weird one saying, oh, we need to set up funnels and we need to do this and we need to have our calendar scheduling and we've got to really take it to the next level. And they thought I was nuts. Well, after about 12 years, that seems to be my cutoff, 11, 12 years, I decided, you know, I'm building my boss's equity. And at the time I was 55. So I was like, shoot, you know, I've got to make a decision here. So I quit my job to start a business. And my goal was to solve this duct tape problem. And I started with a different software program and it ended up, it's not very good. And that's when I met Sean Clark about 2 years in. So it was 2019. Somebody said, you need to talk to Sean Clark. I did. And the rest is history. He said, we're building what you want. And I'm like, oh, please, please. Because I quit my job. I have no income.
Well, thank you for pursuing it, because it's interesting how much the early influence of high level, how it's carried through for everyone else. And
yeah.
I mean, 2019, people were like, oh, that's 5 years ago. And it's like, yeah, that's like a millennium ago in software, right? Where high level is now. I mean, it was just in the beginning. So that's awesome.
Yeah. And you know, those of us that jumped early, we were kind of crazy to do it. I mean, they had no proof that it was going to work, other than Sean is so convincing.
Yeah. I mean, like we've, and that was actually how Melissa and I got to know each other back in 2019. You know, we were both these, you know, two women among not very many women in this industry at the time.
And older. We weren't 20.
Yeah. Well, and there wasn't even many 20-year-olds at the time that there was hardly any women at the time. And so obviously we noticed each other and spent a lot of time in that group learning. There were no videos or even help docs back then. It was just kind of like, hey, there's a new feature. It's funnels and this is how you get to it, you know? And so you just kind of jumped in and you figured out how to make it work. And that was the extent of the training. And back in the day, we literally used the Facebook group to teach each other. We just kind of went back and forth. And so that's how we got to know each other back in 2019.
Yeah. And then we ended up traveling together and we went to Costa Rica. My kids call her Aunt Marla. And they're grown adults.
That there's your sign, right? You're officially in business if your kids are referring to the partnership. Yeah. That's amazing.
Yeah. They were so excited when she came, and it's been a lot because they've seen how hard I've worked to make this work. And so they know she's worked just as hard. And two of my kids are actually in the business now. And so, it's been crazy. And so we've each had our own white label, which we grew.
Yeah.
Mine's in coaching consulting, hers in REI. And then last year we decided, everybody keeps coming to us saying, hey, can you help us? And we said, why don't we partner up, start a business where we help other high levelers? And that's HL Rocket.
Got it. Okay. That's awesome.
Yeah.
So it was, you said last year. So this whole time you guys have just kind of helped each other through your own businesses. And then because of those frequent requests, you're like, all right, let's just partner up and do something here.
We still have our white labels.
Love that. So what it's funny, that's kind of how WAVV was in some ways. Marlo, similar to you, we focused on real estate. So we would partner with real estate CRMs. We would go to the real estate CRM and say, hey, we have this awesome telephony calling texting platform. Instead of building your own, use WAVV, just embed WAVV and you can resell it. And it's awesome. And that was fun, but we had a bunch of people say, hey, we have our own software. We want to integrate your dialer. And we get into it and we're like, this isn't their software. This is this weird product called High Level. Like, what is this? And I didn't want to touch it. I'm like, nope, like not interesting, weird platform, doesn't really fit with what we're doing. And by the third request, I'm like, okay, but you know, we just kind of need to do something. People keep asking for it. Here we are. I mean, now I'm like, High Level is the thing, you know, the other things are cool, but High Level is the thing that we're working on. So I think the principle there of what you guys did was, I mean, you had clients and customers just asking for stuff. And so you found a way to help them. Sometimes in business, we kind of overcomplicate it, you know.
One of the things that we both felt passionate about is having been in the industry so long, right? And seeing so many people coming to High Level who, you know, they either A, had a vision and didn't know how to enable it, they wanted to do something, they just didn't know what. And so, you know, there's kind of two different types of users, right? They're either, you know, an agency or a business that needs help deploying, or they have an idea, but or they have a desire, but they don't know what it is. And so we just decided, you know what, let's see how we can provide a solution for those people who are out there struggling. And that's exactly how HL Rocket was born, because there was so many people that were struggling that would reach out to us. And that's exactly how we, you know, how we've approached it and being able to help them.
Yeah, it's awesome. High level is so powerful, but it is a little bit overwhelming, right? Other software, you come in, right? And there's stuff there, but high level, it's a blank canvas. I have all these tools and instruments to use, but it's a blank canvas. What am I going to do?
That's what we found a lot. A lot of times the business owner, not an agency owner, but a business owner would hear about high level. Somebody would say, hey, you got to buy high level. They'd go there, they'd buy it, and then they'd get it, and then they'd open it up and it was empty. And they're like, well, now what? So they were sold on the vision of what it can do. But then here they're business owners. They don't have time. They don't have the talent, the knowledge to deploy all that. So that's where we really come in. I'd say we probably work more with business owners even than agencies, because they're the ones, if you know marketing and you know software and everything, you can kind of figure it out. That's how we, you know, we paired up and figured it out, but small business owners don't have time for that.
Yeah. And a lot of times that, you know, they need help, whether it's agencies or business owners, they need help understanding the business strategy as much as the implementation of it. A lot of times you, and we're all guilty of this in our own business. We, you know, over time you do it this way, you do it this way. And then you don't see, you've heard the expression, you don't see the forest for the trees, because you've been doing it a certain way all this time. And, you know, having fresh eyes come into your business and say, you know, we've seen other people do it this way, or there's other ways that it can be done, has been really inspiring, I think, for a lot of businesses to understand that, you know, if there's a bottleneck in your business, it's probably, there's probably another way of deploying a solution.
Yeah. So tell me a little bit about, you know, business owners. What are you doing to target business owners? You know, is there a specific ideal customer that is a small business owner? Are there like a niche there that you're going after?
I think it's probably referrals. We get a lot of referrals because we've worked with we've worked with top of the top industry professionals, businesses that are like top three on the Inc. 5000, right?
Gotcha.
Large, massive businesses deploying high level and also small, little bitty, interior design company, you know, small businesses. Swim schools. I mean, like little things. And then also power users. So people know about that, and they, you know, they have good experience with us, and they'll refer people to us because of our experience. And so at this point, we really take a lot of just referrals and even follow up business from those people that we've already worked with.
Yeah, that's awesome. Is it hard to separate, like, from a small business to a big business? How are you able to scale that? Like, it seems like it's different process in place, you know, to onboard and like deliver there. Has that been a headache, or how have you managed that?
I'd say a little bit of everything for me, because that's you're kind of in my wheelhouse now over in production. And yes, to answer your question, it absolutely can be, reinventing the wheel with each client. Because it is, what we do is very, it's heavy consulting in the front end. And so, it can be a different experience with each user. It's not necessarily just SaaS, right? Selling a $297, building a funnel and driving people to it. We literally are building the back ends of their SaaS. We are building the, so for example, we can build, we build the agency, we build their sales magnet or their lead magnet. And then we'll also build this, all of the SaaS and everything that combines it all together. And yeah. So, and anything in between that. So it can, it's different with every client.
So, Marla and Melissa, how do you guys separate your roles in this, in the joint venture piece, right? How are you separating that out? Is there, Melissa, are you wearing like certain hats compared to Marla in that?
Yeah,
I'm
more
business?
Sales and marketing, and Marla runs,
we call
the
it front, front end, back end.
Front end, back end. Yeah. I'm out there talking to people and networking and doing all the stuff. And then we always have a meeting together with the client because we're evaluating the client as much as they're evaluating us.
Right. Yep.
We don't want to go into a project where we're going to fail. And the bigger organization, you know, the bigger companies, there's pros and cons to the small ones. The con, I think you can relate to this, Marla, is the more people on the team that we're working with, the harder it is to get stuff done. Sometimes it's nice to have that sole business owner that goes, here's what I want.
Yep.
And then because now we have a committee and it gets a little more complicated. But, and so we need to make sure that if they can't explain what they want in a very logical way, we can't build it. So they have to be pretty far along in their thinking about how they want it to work. Now, if they've been in business a long time, they know their systems. And then we come in with the high level knowledge and we consult with them. Oh, well, that won't work here. Let's try this, that kind of thing. If they're brand new, we always say we don't work with new business owners because we can't automate what you haven't figured out yet.
Yeah.
If you haven't figured out how to make money, we can't. Software isn't going to fix that.
So that's interesting. It makes sense, right? Of why you wouldn't want to bring on a new business. Is there, do you guys
Although we have.
Lesson learned and you stopped or do you still kind of like,
No, we evaluate. It depends on where that person is in their thinking process. I mean, if they are literally as confused by their business plan and their desire and their budget and all of those things, but if they are clear on what we're building and what their vision is, we'll build it. Absolutely.
Yeah, that's awesome.
And are they action takers? Because in business, there's a lot of people that talk about it.
Yeah.
And, you know, business people that have been around a long time, you know, we can see their results. So we know. But with a new business, it's hard to know whether they're going to make it or not. And when you see somebody, we just finished a project for a gal, one of my customers that, she knew exactly what she wanted. It was all figured out. Her book is launching. I mean, she had it in her mind. She just didn't know how to make it happen in eye level. So for that was great. She's launching her book next month. I mean, it's ready to go.
Yeah. Yep. That does make a lot of sense. And sorry if I'm jumping around a little bit. You guys give me so many good questions. thoughts that I want to ask you questions about. The partnerships are good and bad, right? There's hard things there. And this situation, it's interesting to me because you're both still running your own businesses as well as this joint one. Talk to me about some of the challenges you face there. Like, how do you not have any resentment around like how much time is being spent on the joint venture versus your own things? Are there any things to look out for or lessons learned from that experience?
You want me to take that?
Yeah, that's a good question.
Yeah. So for me, there's good and bad in all of our in our business day to day, right? Like, you know, but Melissa and I have not had any conflicts, and it's really amazing. I think maybe a combination of like the enormous amount of respect that we have for each other, and like just I think general love of you know, like us, and you know, just as friends, as you know, respect for us as business partners. And you know, we just work our business, and we work our business, you know, our old businesses and our existing businesses, and then we work our new business, and it just works for us. We haven't really had, I would say, any true conflict or disagreement about what we're doing or how to do it. We are,
because our intent,
yeah,
our intent is always what's the best way to handle all this.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if and you're an accountable person, I'm an accountable person. Mm-hmm. I think where problems happen is I rely on Marla to do something and she never does it.
Yeah.
And then there's this way, hey, you were going to take care of that. No, she always takes care of her stuff. I always take care of my stuff, and we don't have to worry about it.
This podcast is brought to you by the WAVV dialer. WAVV is the only truly embedded multi-line dialer inside of High Level. With WAVV, you get a ton of benefits of not having to juggle multiple screens and pay for the extra Zapier cost. Look in the description below to find a link to our free 7-day trial. All right, now back to the podcast. Yeah, well, what an amazing partnership. Tell me, like, if you were to go back and start over with High Level, all the knowledge that you had right now, what would you do differently?
Start social faster, you know, because I am very much operations. I'm very much the integrator of, you know, initially I was not fully out in, you know, making my own content and different things like that. So now I actually am very much engaged in content, I do create some content, and I probably, if that's the one thing I could do differently, it would be create more content.
Got it. And Melissa, it seemed like you knew right away what you'd do different.
Yeah, I know exactly what I would do. I'm not sorry I did it the way that we did it, and I'm very happy to now have, you know, it all done. But I would, and someday I'm going to retire, and maybe I'll do it when I retire, but I want to build a business and just use High Level to promote it. We did it for our own, so we know it works. And that's mm-hmm. the one thing I think a lot of high level agencies don't do. They want to go out and sell it right away before they've even used it to grow their own business.
Yeah.
When you use it to grow your own business, the passion, the belief, the knowledge, everything is so, and now I would like, what could I sell that yeah. I could just go nuts in High Level and we could blow it out, because we could do this over and over and over again.
Yeah.
That's the thing.
Yeah. And that is the one thing, is once you really understand High Level, whether, you know, and you've used it in your business, then you can turn around and deploy it across almost any industry. And, you know, especially if you have some good business experience and you can apply that experience to, you know, different industries. So, it's, you know, it's universal. It spans all industries.
Yeah,
my son used it for his wedding. He did all the RSVPs. He did the wedding website. He did all of it.
Yeah. So, I agree with you on that one, Melissa. We internally, we're an app, an integrated app, right? And we'd kind of jumped around on what CRM should we use, how we're doing our email marketing, everything. And then as soon as we got into High Level, we're like, well, we should be dog fooding this, right? I mean, shouldn't we be using this internally? So then we really know the problems that people run into, regardless if it actually integrates with WAVV and makes an impact with our tool. At least we're using the system, so we know. And that has been a huge shift in our business. Then as customers call in, they ask us stuff, instead of being like, I have no idea what you're talking about. This isn't
working.
I mean, we still maybe don't know exactly what they're talking about, right? But it's
on a given day, none of us know, because Sean hasn't done a video yet.
But it's just a different level of conversation that we can have with them. And I've told this to my team. I feel like high level, the group is so close. That Facebook group, like everyone, it is a true community in a way I haven't really experienced. I mean, there's a few things close to it, but not quite the same as high level. And I thought we'd be this outside app coming into it. But as we've been using it, I mean, I feel like we're part of the community because we're using it. Like we are a user of the software. Therefore, we are part of the community. Yeah, we're trying to sell, but we're part of the community. And man, it's so awesome. I think that's what I've maybe been most surprised by. Even at the events and stuff, you're like competing products or kind of competing, you know, some of the services you offer the same, some's different. But even in that situation, everyone's still very helpful and like friendly and like, yeah, that's, you know, that's not quite my expertise. You should go and talk to so-and-so. And it's like, wow, well, thank you. That's awesome. So in closing, I mean, you kind of answered the things that you would do differently. Let's talk about looking ahead. What are you most excited about for this year of 2024? You know, we're almost halfway through. What is making you guys excited about the community or what's going on right now?
One of the things that I'm super excited about is, again, which kind of goes back to why we created HL Rocket to begin with, is seeing so many new people coming in and they have a vision for their business, whether it be an agency or, you know, their roofing business or their flooring business and, you know, whatever type of industry they are in. And we love being able to, you know, they've got a vision and we can help them execute that vision and then let them go and literally keep doing sales while we're building it and then run alongside them as their business grows. So we love that. And that's the thing that I'm really passionate about at this point, because I see so many people coming in so many different industries that want to fast cut, you know, but they don't want a snapshot. I mean, like snapshots are, I mean, they're
somebody else's vision.
Yeah, there's somebody else's vision for that industry. And we have helped so many different businesses and even businesses in the same industry, and they never do it the same.
No,
it's always different, because Susie's over, you know, in sales and, you know, Billy's in whatever, and then you've got so-and-so and so, and then, you know, they're handing off to different people. And so the execution of that business is completely different in how how their software should work is completely different. And so, that's really the future of what we're trying to help people with.
Yeah. I love that. Melissa, what about you? What's exciting for you?
That's always, because for me in sales, knowing that we solved a problem for somebody is the extra paycheck. You know, that's the fun.
Someone asked me as I was explaining high level, what, you know, if you can white label it and you can do these snapshots, like how does anyone differentiate their business from someone else? And it's like, you know, it's a really good question. And it just comes down to the people. And that's, to summarize both of you, it's you as the person. And then together as a team, that's what's making all the difference, right? That's why people come to you and not someone else. And I think that's just awesome. That's the power of having software, but there's still that human element. And ChatGPT and all these AI things we're doing are really powerful tools when you have the right human touch, the right human interface for that to go forward and like do what you want it to do. It makes a big difference. And you can just feel that as we're talking with both of you of, yeah, you want this to work right, go to Marla and Melissa, you're going to get taken care of because they understand you, they'll work through that and deliver what you need, not just a snapshot.
Make it work, I mean, you really have to be clear on your business goals, and then we have to know high level. And so when we meet with people and we just have our free session, I can't tell you how many times people walk away going, oh my gosh, this alone was so powerful, because the questions we're asking and how did you, you know, how is that going to connect to this? And where, if somebody doesn't go the perfect route that you want them to, what has to happen if they don't? And, you know, we're pulling from them and we're making them expand on their vision of their business. And that's the fun stuff, you know, where they get excited and they can start seeing how this is all going to work. And they don't have to understand how. We can do the how. And then, but we train them once it's done so that they can just, and then, you know, go in and tweak things.
As needed. And I think it's always one of the favorite parts of the entire process is helping people identify manual activities that there are repetitive in their organization that can be pulled in to an automation, you know, and a lot of times businesses don't even realize how much money they're wasting in just that, you know, just the human, the human hours that are going into an activity that could be automated.
We're a perfect example of that, because people say, well, how is it that you two can spend an hour with us and you guys own several businesses? It's because it's automated. We are here so that we can have a human connection. That's where we're supposed to be, not doing manual actions. And so if we're just a small little team, you know, we're not a huge organization. But when you automate and you get it all flowing like that, that's frees you up to do the human things.
It's same thing with AI, right? Yeah. You know, a lot of initially people think, well, I don't want to get rid of, you know, my front end person that, you know, and it's like, well, you'd be surprised how much you can take that person and put them and move them into more productive, potentially even revenue generating activities for your business rather than mundane repetitive task. And so it's not about the elimination of positions. It's about allowing the people that are in your organization to grow and serve you in better capacity.
It was the same thing in robotics. Everybody's like, well, you're going to put a robot and then nobody's going to have a job anymore. And it's like, the robots are doing the dangerous, monotonous, boring jobs that nobody can keep filled. And now we give that to a robot and we take those people and we educate them to go on to more important things.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, welding doesn't have to be done by a human.
Well, and the person
something valuable to do.
Yeah. And then they can do things that they actually get a lot more satisfaction out of doing, right? Instead of the mundane things, it's like, yeah, that's automated. That frees up my time to now do the things I want to be doing.
Yes. Yeah.
Well, thank you both so much. Really appreciate it. Excited to see what you guys are doing right now, as well as the future. Appreciate you being on the show. Thank you again.
Thank you.
Thank you.